Okay, so now let's go and see what are the types of XPath. Okay, types of XPath. Okay, so there are two types of XPath. So one is absolute. Okay, and second type is relative XPath. Okay. So let us go and see what exactly the absolute XPath mean. Okay. So absolute XPath means it start from first, or you can say the root element. Okay. Root element in HTML DOM. Okay, and it will traverse up to desired element. Okay, so it will start from the first and root element in HTML DOM and up to the desired element is found. Okay, that means in HTML document, our document start with the HTML tag, right? Okay, so it will start with this HTML root, okay, and it will traverse, okay, it will traverse until you get your desired node, or desired node you can say, or desired element. Okay. Okay, so for example, I will show you practically. So let's go to Facebook. Okay, and just right click inspect. Okay, so here you just have to right click on this. Okay, this row is representing the email text box. Okay, so you just have to go copy, and here you will find copy full XPath. Okay, so this will give you absolute XPath value. Okay, so basically our absolute XPath will start from this first node, okay, and it will travel from HTML tag to our desired input. Okay, so let's see, I have copied it, let's see how it looks like. Okay, as you can see, let me zoom out. Okay, as you can see, the length of absolute XPath. Okay, so as you can see, it start from HTML. Okay, let me do like that. Okay, quite easy. Okay, so it start from HTML, then it goes to body. Okay, because our element is under this body. Okay, then it will go to div. Okay, so it comes to body. Okay, in body our element, okay, so body has two childs here. It has this div, it has several childs, but our element, you can see like the, like this, this is the first child, this is the second. Okay, so in second, what is the value it is showing? Div. Okay, div1. Okay, so in the first child only our element is there, right? It's highlighting the entire page. That means it's somewhere there in the div tag. So okay, so that's why it goes under the div, and this is called as the indexing. Okay, we will see in detail what exactly and how we use this indexing. Okay, so just as of now, just understand that giving in square bracket, that means we need to go to the first div. Okay, after body, if there are several divs displayed, then by showing this indexing, okay, by showing this one index, that means you need to go to the first div. Okay, once you go to the first div, it's going to the, okay, div means second div. Okay, so this div, it has two child, means two divs are there. Okay, so in first it is not highlighting. In second, it is highlighting this row, right? means it is somewhere inside the second. Okay, so likewise absolute XPath uses different nodes and tags right from the first HTML tag, and it will travel until we will get to the input tag. Okay, so this is our desired and this is our first. Okay, so that's what we saw. It will start from HTML and to the desired node of element. Okay, so let us go and check if it is correct or not. It will be correct, but as per last lecture I have suggested that always use Control F and paste your XPath here and make sure that it is showing one of one. Okay, so this absolute XPath is correct. Okay, but absolute XPath is never recommended to use in your Selenium script, because as you can see its length is too high, you know, it's too long, and it starts from the first node and until the desired node. But what if the web developer or project they inserted some other div or other element in between this? Okay, because absolute XPath is dependent upon the position. Okay, so it depends upon the position, and by using indexing we are able to reach to the desired node. Okay, so if in future they inserted some 2 to 3 elements in this, okay, so whatever the absolute XPath we have used in our Selenium, that will not work in that. Okay, from that point, okay, once a new element is inserted here in DOM, then our this old absolute XPath will not work. Okay, so every time you need to change your position, then okay, so if here they added one more div, okay, so then again you need to come here and change your absolute XPath like this. Okay, come to div, then if they added two more divs in after that, so go to div, then go to second div, like that. So you need to keep updating your absolute XPath. Okay, so which is not feasible, and which is it's time consuming and very complex thing. Okay, so that's why it is never recommended. Okay, so we are going to use the relative XPath in our whole Selenium theoretical whole Selenium learning. So we okay, so we are going to use relative XPath because of this reason. Okay, so just for the sake of interviews and knowledge point of view, I have explained what exactly the absolute XPath, okay, and how it is get generated. Okay, start from the first and then traverse up to the desired node. Okay, so you don't have to worry about this absolute XPath, because we are not going to use it in our Selenium. So just have some knowledge. If in interview they ask you, just you will be able to answer in this way. Okay, okay, so let us move to our second relative XPath, second type relative XPath. Okay, so here I will just put some note, will never in Selenium as it is position dependent. Okay, position dependence means if in future this position of the input tag changes, this whatever the absolute XPath will not work. Okay, so it's not feasible to change it every time. Okay, every time we changes or add more element in HTML DOM. Okay, so just for sake of information, so let us go and see what exactly relative XPath means. So relative XPath, by using you can directly go to the desired node. Okay, you can directly go to the desired node or element. No need to start with root node. Okay, so basic syntax I will tell you, then you will understand more. Basic syntax. So how you can directly jump into the desired node? Okay, so basic syntax of relative XPath is double slash tag, then square bracket, at the rate, we will use attributes of the elements, is equal to, in single quote, attributes value. Okay, very simple. You have to give this in single quote. Okay, so let's see what is it actually practically. So you can just you can inspect this again, anyone. Okay, so for the same field we are going to use this input tag. Okay, all these in the blue line, you can see all these are the attributes, okay, associated with this text field. Okay, so there are multiple attributes available. Okay, sometimes in real time you will not find more than one, or sometimes there will not be any attributes. Okay, so that time you need to use the different functions, okay, that we are going to see in after some time. But as of now, as we have several attributes available, you can use this to get to the desired element. Okay, so how you can create a relative XPath for this using this syntax? Okay, using this syntax is double slash input, right? It has input tag at the rate. Okay, so you can use any of the attribute here as of now. So you can use type, its value is email, or you can use class, its value is in double quote, okay, or name, or ID, or date, test ID also. Okay, as per the basic testing locating strategy, you can use directly by dot ID also, but sometimes this ID or name, class will not be available for particular element. Okay, so that time you can use another attributes available. So let's go and use type. Type is equal to email. At the rate, type is equal to single slash. You can use double slash also, but make a habit of using the single slash. Okay, you can use here double slash also. Okay, double quotes, I mean, sorry. Okay, but make a use of make a habit of using the single quote. Okay, so inside it you have to give the value. Okay, so let's go and check if it is correct or not. Control C and here, okay, so Control F. So here on right side you can see it is showing one of one. That means our relative XPath is correct, and it is finding and it is locating our web element uniquely. Okay, it has identified this text box uniquely, as it is showing one of one. Okay, so this is very handy method how to verify your XPath in browser itself. Okay, so if you see one of one, then you can directly use this in your Selenium script. Okay, so this is only the basic syntax and basic form we see about the relative XPath. Okay, so let us go and dig more into this. Okay, okay, so let us use another attribute. Let's say, for example, I need to use this name or ID. Let's say name. So here only what you have to do, attribute you need to change. Let's say ID is equal to email. Okay, it's also working. And if you change to name also, this time also it will work, because we are going write attributes name and write attributes value. Okay, so this you can go in the double quote also. Just I will show you practically. Okay, both are working, but thing is, in Selenium we are going to use by dot likewise driver dot find element, right, and bracket by dot let's say x path, and in this is a method, and in double quote we need to provide. So if you use double quote, okay, if you use double quote instead of this single quote, it will give you an error, okay, because double quote, inside double quote is not allowed in Java, right? So you have to convert this into single, okay. So it's better to have a habit to add the attributes value in a single quote. Okay, so lighting line here. Okay, so this is our relative x path. So we'll be able to get better. So here that syntax we use tag here. So you can provide this double slash where means using the tag, that means go and find the element with input tag. Okay, so there is another way that if you don't want to use or don't want to mention tag, then there is a method that you can use star. Okay, star means any tag. Okay, it can be input, it can be button, it can be div. So scan with any tag and this will be the same. So I will never recommend this as well to use the star. Always specify whatever the tag you want for the specific element. Okay, so there always be some tag present for element. Okay, so you need to provide actually what a tag is there in the HTML DOM. Okay, so next you will see. Okay, this is the. Okay, so we see the basic syntax, double slash, tag, and then attributes. Okay, so next is next thing we will see what is. You can see here we have used double slash and single slash. So what is double slash and single slash? Okay, so first we will see what is double slash. Okay, so using double slash you are telling and you are able to find an element with entire HTML document. That means if you use this double slash input, that means go and find input tag element in all the HTML DOM, okay, in complete HTML DOM document. Okay, it can be anywhere, right? Okay, find in entire DOM, anywhere it is present. Okay, so if you use @ input, that means it should go and check all the input tags in the HTML DOM, no matter where it present, at the first place or at 10th element or what, at the end. Okay, so if you write, okay, double slash input, so as you can see it has scanned 47 elements which has input tag. Okay, in whole HTML document it has found 47 elements having input tag. Okay, so that's how you use the double slash. Okay, so if you want to find element in anywhere, okay, so we always start with the double slash. And so this is the syntax of relative XPath, where it will start always with the double slash. Okay, that means start from anywhere and find it anywhere in the HTML DOM. Okay. Okay, so let us go and see what is single slash. Okay, so single slash is used to go to the immediate node. Okay, immediate node or element, you can say, after the current node. Okay, so in absolute XPath, as you can see, it has used only single slash. Okay, there is no double slash. Okay, because we are traversing from one node to another. Okay, so it's finding immediate dues after this body. Okay, then immediate second due after this first due. Okay, likewise, after immediate table node after this form. That means I will show you. Let's say, okay, let us see. Okay, for example, you can see that this T body has, okay, two nodes. Okay, so all these three TR are called as immediate nodes after this T body. Okay, so if you want to go to this T body after go to this TR after T body, okay, so how you can go? First let us create XPath. Okay, let us start with the T body directly. Okay, using double slash T body. Okay, after T body, if you want to go to this TR, okay, so all these TR are immediate one, means single slash TR. So as you can see in right hand side, it has given the three. Okay, so what three is representing? There are three immediate nodes after the T body. Okay, you can also call them as childs, and this is the parent. Okay, so immediate means immediate is does not mean that it should be the first. Okay, it means it can be first or second or third. Okay, but if you expand this, that does not mean like inside element also you can go. You can only reach up to the immediate nodes using the single slash. Okay, then if you want to go to the TD, okay, so you can use here double slash. I can already told you, using double slash you can reach to any node. Okay, okay, it doesn't mean it is required to be a immediate one to the T body. From T body we directly jump on to the TD using double slash. Okay, so likewise you can use single slash and double slash. Okay, as per your requirement you can use it. Okay, so what we have done is here single slash used to go to immediate node and element after the current node. Okay, so immediate does not mean a first node. Okay, remember this, it should not it's not like it should be first node. Okay, so that's about this. Then okay, so we have seen like double slash you can use to find element. It can be anywhere. Okay, that means using double slash you can go from T body to TD. Okay, so you can see that this TR T body, for example, this is a parent. Okay, and this parent has three child. Okay, so using single slash you can just move to the childs of this parent. Okay, all these TD are grandchild of this T body. Okay, okay, so you cannot use single slash to go to the grandchild. Okay, you can only move to child element. Okay, the immediate one, the immediate childs of this parent. Okay, so this is also a node that using double slash you can go to. Okay, you can go to child or grandchild or grand grandchild, you can say. Okay, so from anywhere you can go using double slash, right? So in single slash you cannot go to grandchild. Okay, you can only go to child. Okay, that is the difference. Okay, so that's why double slash is very useful while creating our XPath. Okay, so let's move to the next thing. Okay, now let's go and see how you can traverse in reverse direction. Okay, so until now we have just moving from one node to another node in forward direction, right? Okay, so let me just give numbers here. Traverse in reverse direction. Okay, so let's see, I will show you. So for example, you want to go from this label, okay, from this node to TD, okay, means from child to the parent. Or if you want to go from label to TD, then you want to go to TR, and then you want to go to T body, means you need to traverse in reverse direction. So how can you do that? So let us create first a relative XPath for this label node. So it can be label bracket at the rate, we have four attribute, it's equal to its value is email. Okay, so now we are at here. Now if you use slash dot dot, okay, do you see that it went to TD? Okay, again you use dot dot, again it went to the previous node. Okay, so likewise if you keep using this, okay, it will go to the first node. Okay, after you use so many this combination, it can go to the HTML tag. Okay, so how you can move in reverse direction using slash dot dot. Okay, so just for example I will put it here. Okay, example use slash dot dot after current node. Okay, so it's sometimes it's very useful, very easily you can traverse in reverse direction, okay, using this. Okay, so next